Can't get enough of your favorite Colonial sports? Follow RMU Athletics on social media at RMU Athletics on Twitter, RMU Athletics on Instagram, and be sure to like our page on Facebook at Robert Morris University Athletics. Go Colonials!
Hey there, Colonial fans! It's time to meet our Student Athletes of the Week, sponsored by People's Gas. This week, we celebrate Malik Padaway from men's basketball and Alex Tonge from men's hockey. Senior forward Malik Padaway finished up non-conference play with a double-double in the Colonials' huge blowout against Hood on Saturday, with 18 points and 10 rebounds. He shot .889 from the field, helping the Colonials achieve their second-highest field goal percentage in program history. Senior forward Alex Tonge scored two goals in the Colonials' 3-1 win over AIC on Sunday, with his 7th and 8th goals of the season. Tonge's game winner came just 8 seconds into the third period on a breakaway and puts him 6th place on the program's all-time scoring list. Congratulations to our Student Athletes of the Week. For more, visit rmucolonials.com and remember to use the hashtag ColonialPride.
Here at the RMU Island Sports Center, ready for the Three Rivers Classic. I'm Matt Geica, talking to senior captain Brandon Watt. And Brandon, a short week coming off the trip to AIC where you guys split. Do you feel like that's maybe a good thing because you can keep that momentum going?
Yeah, I mean, it was nice to get a couple games in early as soon as we came back from break. Nice to get our legs under us, especially after we had a little bit of a longer break over Christmas this year. Usually like we play the Three Rivers as soon as we get back. So I think the trip to AAC definitely helped us get back and into the swing of things before we start the tourney.
I was talking to Alex Tonge after the Sunday game up there in Massachusetts. He said he thought it might be an advantage to get those two games and feel like you're back in the swing of things. Do you feel the same way?
Yeah, for sure. Like I said, in the past years, we came back and those were the first games we've played, especially playing teams from out of conference. You know, it's always kind of a different game. So it was nice to get down to Springfield for a road trip and get a couple of games under us.
So far this season, including out there at Springfield, it's been a very successful defensive season for your team. It's a departure from what the Colonials are used to being about. Why do you think the D has been such a lockdown factor this year?
I think it all starts with our goalie, Frankie. Sometimes I think this year we haven't exactly found a way to score goals like we have in the past. So in order to win hockey games when you're not putting up, 4 or 5 goals a game, is playing sound defensively. And I think down the stretch it's certainly going to help us as long as we continue to find ways to score goals. I think our power play is starting to click a little bit more now. So the fact that we can bear down defensively will definitely help us down the stretch.
That's been a different type of a season for you, obviously, as team captain. That's an increased responsibility, but also you had some injuries to battle through too. So how do you feel where you're at emotionally, or how have you kept your confidence up as now you're working your way back into things?
Yeah, I mean, it's kind of been the same way for the past 2 years for me, battling some injuries. But, I think it's been good that the coaches have supported me the whole time, and, teammates have helped me keep my confidence up. Kind of sad to say, but I guess I'm kind of used to it by now, just working my way back in and trying to find my legs and whatnot, especially coming off an injury.
Now, last thing for you, the Three Rivers Classic, you've been on the winning side, and you've also seen another team hoist the Confluence Cup. How important is this weekend? Because it's right in the middle of the season, it's not Atlantic hockey play, but you get a chance to put your skills and your team's ability on display for the entire nation, really.
I think it's cool. It's definitely a good experience for us. We get to play teams that, we don't normally see, especially teams coming from out of conference. And I think it's also a huge turning point in the season, too. The first 2 years we were able to win, which was nice, and it kind of brought our team closer. And even last year, we kind of learned a little bit about our team. And I think the past 3 years, this tournament really kind of defined who we were in terms of, bringing us all together for the stretch drive.
Come see the Colonials, the Muse Sports Complex in Cranberry, 8 o'clock. They have the nightcap on Friday against Brown University, then St. Cloud State or Union the second day at PPG Paints Arena.
Man, you've got a lot going on, and you're making it happen. But you still need to eat. You need takeout. Eaton Park is the answer. A huge menu that everyone can agree on, no matter what you're hungry for. Easy online ordering to get the order right and get it the way you want it. Plus, fast and easy pickup windows so you can get your order and stay in your car. Eaton Park for takeout. Quick, easy, delicious.
Today you bought breakfast for your team using Apple Pay. Today you used Clearview's mobile app with Touch ID and Bill Payer to pay your bills, leaving you more time to train for that 5K. And today you used Mobile Deposit to safely deposit a check from home without a trip to a branch. At Clearview Federal Credit Union, technology that saves time makes time for more important things. Clearview Federal Credit Union, the next generation of personal banking.
I was always fairly into education. I took it serious, and I'd always thought about the additional education, but I just never really thought I'd have the time to do it.
My dad and my brother got their MBA before I did, so they always said that they were in the master's club, and I wasn't in it. So then when I finished mine, Joe wasn't in the club, so he felt the need to join our club.
So I'm trying to balance this work and school and home life, and then we find out in October that we're expecting a baby. It's just going to be a whole new adventure and just a lot of exciting things going on in our life.
I went all over the country, 12 hospitals, 7 doctors, 6 bronchoscopies. No one could figure out what was wrong with me. I couldn't breathe. I couldn't make it from here to the door. Finally, the last doctor we saw told us to go to UPMC. That hospital saved my life. I can't explain how good it felt to unplug my chair. I have a real life back. I didn't choose to have severe asthma, but I did choose UPMC.
And we welcome you to the Lemieux Sports Complex here in Cranberry Township, Pennsylvania. The first game of the 2019 Three Rivers Classic as the St. Cloud State University Huskies take on the Union College Dutchmen here on RMU Athletics. We thank you for tuning in. My name is Spencer Witt. Logan Carney will be beside me. And Logan, it should be a good one today. St. Cloud State, the number one team in the nation, only one loss so far this season. Union College, 14th themselves. They've had a good season so far as well.
Yes, it's the best start in St. Cloud State University's history, best 16-game start in their program's history. Of course, Union, though, the last time, very interesting statistic that I found, last time they took down a number one team back in 2013, it was not only St. Cloud State University.
So we'll look to see. Union will try and give somewhat of an upset, per se. Once again, the winner of this game will play in the championship game of the Three Rivers Classic tomorrow evening at 8 o'clock. They'll play the winner of Robert Morris and Brown, which will be later tonight as well. You'll be able to watch that one here on RMU Athletics as well. Both teams getting their respective sides. We'll take a look at the goaltenders real quick here. They were mentioned before for St. Cloud State. It's number 34, David Renick, the sophomore out of Slovakia, will get the call tonight. And for Union College, it's Darian Hansen who's going to get the start. 9 games played so far this season. He split time with Jake Kapinski. We're underway here at the Lemieux Sports Complex, sent around into the corner, and a couple players fighting for it. Taken out by St. Cloud State. They're in their black uniforms with red lines on the side. Stripes. Union College is in white with black sleeves. Still fighting for it in the corner of St. Cloud State's side. And the Huskies are finally able to get it out. And number 19 will send it all the way down. That's Sam Henkes. Henkes cycling around, and it's bounced off the boards, and it'll go right back to St. Cloud State, where it's out of the reach of one player, and Union College will get to it. Number 27, that's Sebastian Vidmar. They're taking over Brodzinski with a shot, and that one will be collected. The first shot of the game, and it's collected by Union College's goaltender, Darian Hansen.
Some interesting things about Union, as we saw, obviously a save, but their offense averaging just over 33 shots per game. That is 7th in the country right now. So the ability to generate those shots, is prevalent, as you say the least, for Union.
Another shot, and that one will be collected and caught by Hansen. So 2 quick shots in a row for St. Cloud State. Another faceoff to the left of Hansen. Face-off this time won by St. Cloud State. They fight for it in the corner. Number 3, that's Jack Paling, one of the twins on this team for St. Cloud State. Jack and Nick Paling, both on the same line and both currently out there right now.
Yes, and their younger brother currently playing for Team USA in the World Juniors Championship.
That one deflecting off a player and out of bounds, or into the corner, excuse me. Cycle back, though, to the blue line. Sent over to number 12. That's Jack Ashawn. It bounces around, big hit in front, but still behind the net. Thrown in front and collected by Hansen. And Hansen will cover it up. So it's been St. Cloud State. About 2 minutes have gone by so far, but all of them offensively.
Yeah, I mean, they have the best goal differential in the country. They're one of the top in the country in both scoring and in goals against. They're the number one team in the country for a reason, and they've shown it so far. Just a minute 30 in, but so far they look like the number one team.
Face off this time to the right of Hansen, and it's won by Union College. They'll push it down past their blue line, where St. Cloud State will throw it right back down into the corner, taken by number 21 for Union College. That's Michael Ryan battling for it. Ryan again, but St. Cloud State with it again. Meyer, that one blocked in front. And pushed away, a nice defensive play by number 27, Sebastian Vidmar, the assistant captain for Union College. Behind the net, still fighting for it in front. Union College is able to maintain possession. Bouncing off the boards, keeping it inside the lines. Line judge says that it was still in, so no offsides. Right in front, nobody to help that one, though, for Union College. And St. Cloud State will just push it right back down where it's recollected by Michael Ryan. Klaus Kolias with it. Kolias will go all the way down behind the net, dropping it off, but nobody there for it. Sent in front and deflected away by the netminder for St. Cloud State. That's Rennick. Still in St. Cloud State's side, the Huskies are going to try and get it out. They bounce it off the boards and all the way down. It goes all the way down. No icing is the call as it didn't reach the red line. And taken by Union College. Campbell with it. Campbell flipping it forward all the way down the other side of the ice. Icing is waved off, actually. So the Huskies will move forward. Some pressure on them. They try and move it forward again. Union College will get it, and they'll retreat back. Estes forward by number two, Taylor Brierley, excuse me. Bouncing around in front. Brierley with it again. Brierley dropping off. Estes with a drive, and that one off the boards. Going wide. Still fighting for it. A shot taken, and that one got deflected away by a stick, so not even getting to the goaltender. One player going down. Battling for it a couple times. And back behind the net, where the Huskies will try and cycle it around. They will. But it will be an icing call on St. Cloud State. So a face-off will be in the Husky zone.
Yeah, I'm going to go back a little bit to Darian Hansen, the goalie today for Union, getting the start over Jake Cupsey. Darian, 2.2 goals against average so far this year, 2.22. That would rank fourth all time if they were minimum, if he met the minimum decisions for Union. And his save percentage so far, .920. That'd be third all time if he met the minimum.
Of course, still plenty of time remaining in this season. Both goaltenders have split time, 8 games played for Kupski and 9 for Hansen. Faceoff for Union College is one, and they keep it in the zone where it goes behind the goaltender and flipped all the way back down, where it looks like it will be another icing. So with 15 minutes, 42 seconds remaining, neither team has yet to score. We've seen some offense from both sides, more or less. St. Cloud State, they had a lot of pressure early on in the first period. Union College, though, got their offense going a little bit, a couple shots, but nothing that Rennick couldn't handle. Face off won by the Dutchman. It goes all the way back around where it jumps off the stick of number 7, Estes. Head into the bench, and so we'll have a face off. And neutral ice.
Just like you said, very even game so far. St. Cloud, you know, they came out hot early, generated a lot of shots, but Union now has been in control for the past couple of minutes, just going back and forth. Top 25 matchup, if you could say so.
A big matchup for both of these sides, of course. Like we mentioned before, St. Cloud State, only one loss so far this season. There's a shot, taking a rebound, and it bounces off of Estes. And he'll push it forward. St. Cloud State with it again, though. Once again, the Huskies have only lost one game so far as that one into the netting and out of play. That was against Northeastern early on this season.
Yeah, and right before that, Union defeated Northeastern.
Twice.
Northeastern, number 12 in the country at that time. That was the week before Northeastern would go on to defeat St. Cloud State. So, common opponent-wise, they're Union does have the edge.
One of the big common opponents that they have. Face-off taken and won by Union College. It cycled all the way around and then pushed forward by the Dutchman. Battling forward in the corner, a couple players. It goes off of one skate. The Huskies trying to move forward, but they're not able to. Number 17 gets it. Shot taken, and that one will be stopped by the netminder, Rennick. So a media timeout. We'll just go over real quick. Like you mentioned before, a lot of time here, but this is a very good game for both of these sides when it comes to the exposure, when it comes to strength of schedule. Both of these teams, you know, obviously top 15 in the nation. If you're getting down into the nitty-gritty of the end of the season, having wins against either side, depending on who wins, is a big thing for you.
Yeah, and this is it's probably the best matchup, you know, in the Three Rivers Classic, depending on who wins in the game tonight. Robert Morris Brown will take on the winner of this game. But this is between two top 15 teams, two top 25, depending on which one you want to use. And really, I mean, they're even. Common opponent-wise, they're pretty similar. Both teams coming out today, they're playing a pretty even game. So out of all the four games that will happen in this tournament, I had to correct myself three times there, but out of the four games in this tournament, this is probably the one to watch.
Yeah, definitely for that. Again, Robert Morris will take on Brown later on this evening at 8 o'clock. That game will, of course, be live-streamed on RMU Athletics as well. Battling for a nice defensive play there. Offensive, I should say. Parker Fu is able to push forward and get the puck into the corner, but St. Cloud with a two-on-two rush. Trying to get around defender. That's number 28, Kevin Fitzgerald. But Fitzgerald was stood up by a defender for Union College. Fitzgerald still going for this puck, though, but it's taken by Ryan. The Dutchman behind their own net will stop some pressure on them. They'll just push it forward with a bad pass, an errant pass at that, and St. Cloud State keeping it in. Meyer behind the net for Miller. Miller with a defender on him. Tries to go back and he'll drop it off. Meyer with a drive and that one in front. Still in front and taken by number 28 for Union College. That one goes off a defender. Player injured, number 5 for the Dutchman. Very slow to get off the ice. It looked like he took that puck to the hand area, the wrist area.
Yeah, he looked to be in some pain. Of course, you don't like to speculate on these type of things, but yeah, number 5 for Union, Kolilas.
Yeah, Voss Kolilas getting some work. Odd man rush for Union College, but it got stopped in a nice defensive play from a stick from the Huskies. The Huskies will try and push forward, but good steal from Estes. Estes dropping it off. Shot taken. That one stopped and pushed away by Rennick. In front again, and that one goes wide. Now go into the bench area of St. Cloud State. And play will stop. With 13 minutes and 4 seconds remaining. Immediate timeout. As we mentioned before, only 4 losses for Union College. The national champions in 2014. Trying to get back to that again this year. That'll be 5 years ago. Up this coming April, I believe, is when the end of the season, in April, May area.
Yeah, interesting. Union hockey, they've taken on another university in this tournament, Brown. There is obviously a good chance that they will face Brown in the next game. It's a 50-50 chance, but they took on Brown earlier this year, and they went to overtime and tied 3-3. That was back on December 7th when they took on a couple Ivy League teams. They would end up falling to Yale the next week, or next day.
The Ivy League always getting them. So here at the Lemieux Sports Complex, of course, this is the Pittsburgh Penguins practice facility. Team's having to play here tonight, and they'll play at PPG Paints Arena tomorrow.
Yeah, you know it's a Pittsburgh facility when you see RMU head coach Derek Schooley walk around with a big Steeler blanket.
It's cold in here. It's cold in every ice arena, but it's pretty cold in here. One of the state-of-the-art facilities. The Penguins, you know, back-to-back champions. Practice makes perfect, and they made perfection 2 years in a row. Face-off won by St. Cloud State. We're back underway. 12 minutes and 57 seconds remaining in the first period. It's been a very long first period, it seems like. No goals so far. Only a handful of shots between both teams. Behind the net, battling for it. They'll drop it off. Brierley cycles it over. Back behind the net. That one just out of the reach of Campbell, so St. Cloud State will push forward. A 2-on-2 break. Trying to get around the defender was number 14 for St. Cloud State. Patrick Newell. Not able to as the defenders were there. Walker with it now for Union. He'll push forward. 2-on-2 rush. A shot taken. That one deflects off a stick. And it'll bounce away. Back behind the net. For Parker, or for, excuse me, that's for St. Cloud, that's for Union. It was Jimmy Schultz with it for St. Cloud State. Into the corner. We're trying to fake his move with Kolias. Good to see Kolias back on the ice after taking a bit of an injury and slowly skating off. He's back on and resume playing. Schultz with it, that one blocked away. Good defense from number 13. Pat Zachary, Emailophone. And it goes all the way behind St. Cloud State. Bouncing around, and that was an errant puck that jumped over the stick of Walker. Oh my goodness, Jack Adams had a big opportunity in front, but I believe it got deflected after Walker was able to recollect himself. Pushing forward, Sam Morton. Morton bouncing it off, going around a defender and into the corner. Four players fighting for it. The Huskies are the ones that come out with it. Bouncing off the wall, and they'll move forward. Miller with it. Miller takes a shot. That one's deflected away by Hansen. Caught by Ryan and dropped down in front of him, where he's behind the net, and he'll drop it off to number 15. Sends it over to Vidmar. Or excuse me, Vidmar. Vidmar losing that one. And it's taken right back by Luke Jaycox. Luke Jaycox, the extra defender for St. Cloud State. So he'll bounce around with a couple different lines. And Jaycox with it behind his own net, dropping it off to his line mate right now, Brandon Bushy. Bushy forward, that puck bouncing around and perfectly dropped off. A shot taken in that one high for number 55, Micah Ilvanen, excuse me. A big, huge rush for Ilvanen. He was not able to put it in the back of the net. Probably the best opportunity of the day for St. Cloud State. Huskies are going to be offside, a delayed offside, so they'll just come back. Union College pushing it forward. No icing on that one. The Huskies will have to fight for it as well as the Dutchman, and the Huskies are the ones that come out with it. Almost pickpocketed away from number 19. That's Sam Henkes. Kolias falling over, Estes. Estes, a nice move to get around one defender, bouncing her off a couple players though, and Newell will try and fight for it with Kolias. Kolias moving forward, he pushes it forward to Emailophone, and Emailophone will send it all the way down. Union College will change their lines. 9 minutes remaining in the first period. St. Cloud State, Union College. Nothing right now. Big hit in open ice here by the captain for St. Cloud State. Well, number 22, Jimmy Schultz, goes behind the ice. Or behind the net, excuse me, and it will be a face-off to the left of Hansen.
Yeah, and Spencer, a little bit more statistics or regarding this, or facts regarding this. A matchup today is, well, we go to a media timeout before the face-off. St. Cloud State, 10-game unbeaten streak right now. It's the longest in the country. These two teams, though, their matchup overall, 2-3-1 in terms of Union. So Union 2-3-2 against St. Cloud State. Pretty evenly divided. I mean, as we, you know, seen today, pretty even game.
Yeah, pretty even game so far. And
you know, looking at the statistics, St. Cloud State 11 shots so far, Union 10, St. Cloud State 6 on goal, Union 4.
Of course, not a team has had a penalty yet.
They've both won 5 faceoffs.
You can't get any more even than that, honestly. About halfway through, 8 minutes and 47 seconds remaining in the first. Let's take a look at some of the replays. Looking at it, some good shots here. Like I said before, at the Lemieux Sports Complex, the practice facility of the Pittsburgh Penguins. Crowd is starting to fill in a little bit here. So still some seating area left, but you know, you gotta get around a couple people if you wanna sit down. So it's starting to fill in. Both of these teams, I'll tell you what, travel well. We've seen a lot of fans for both sides.
I mean, that's what happens when you're a top 25 team, 14-1. it is a little bit disappointing that this isn't going to be at PPG Paints, where the tournament is typically held.
First time it has not been held at PPG or Consol at the time. At least only for the first game. Of course, tomorrow, both of these teams will be guaranteed to play at PPG tomorrow, depending on how they finish today is what time they'll play and what game they'll play. Behind St. Cloud State's net, battling for it, two players, number 10 and 22. And it's won by Union College, but then intercepted by St. Cloud State. They'll try and push forward. Poling. That one knocked down. A high stick is what they're looking for. No call on that one. A couple fans putting their hands up in the air looking for high stick, but nothing called. Schull bouncing that one off the boards. Poling with it. I said Poling before. Looking for his brother there right in front of the net, but not able to get it to him. Fu dropping it off to Ryan. That one off the boards. Walker with it. Odd man rush. Walker dropping it off. Jackson with a shot, and that one deflected away. Saved by Hansen. A good save by Hansen. St. Cloud State still with it, though, in front. But Ryan was able to push it forward for Union College. Doski's pushing forward. Miller dropping it off to Walker. Walker taking a shot, and Hansen blocks it away. Miller still with it, though. Miller behind the net, wrapping around. Does not able to get it in front, though. Walker was in front along with Jackson. Union will push forward. Kolias with a breakaway. Kolias makes one move, but he loses the puck. Not able to take a shot. Still with Union College, excuse me. Fighting for it. That one went by the goaltender, Rennick. And it bounces away, so a big breakaway for Kolias was not able to score. Vidmar with a shot, looking for the rebound, but not able to get to it. Throwing it in front, but it goes off of one player. Might have went off their own player, actually. Go back to Estes. Estes over to Kolias. Estes with it. Estes goes past the blue line. Or he'll push it around. A player taken down there. No call on that one. Actually, correction. Lyman going to stop things. And so we'll have a face-off in St. Cloud State zone. To the right. Of the netminder, Rennick.
Yeah, to go back to that breakaway, Rennick, great move to showing no open area of the goal. Shows you why he's one of the better netminders in the country. Of course, under 2 goals against average on this season. Just 1.88 so far in the year.
Face-off one by Union College, but it's taken over by St. Cloud State. Pushing forward is Newell. Newell's got Mayer. Let this throw it over into the corner, though. It bounces around. It's taken by the Dutchman. A bad bounce, though, off of the boards. Feynman's able to come up and get it, though. And drop it back off to Campbell. 5 minutes and 55 seconds remaining in the first period. Neither team is yet to score. But the question is, will I jinx that, yes or no? Into the corner. But kept in by Union College, only momentarily, though. It goes all the way back down, where Kolias will send it forward, a delayed offsides. They're able to change their lines. The Dutchman. Almost called them the Friars. Providence was here last year. That's why I had Friars in my head. Both of these teams, black and red uniforms, although you'd argue Union College is more maroon than red. Both having shades of red. Shot taken, and it's deflected away by Rennick. Still in St. Cloud State zone, but it's taken out. All the way back behind the red line, Kolias with it. Kolias pushing it forward, where it's touched forward, but not too far for Union College. Poling got a piece of it, and he'll get it back. That's Jack Poling. John Lazotte with it, and they push it around. St. Cloud State trying to get it out, and they finally will as it goes off of the skate of a Dutchman player. Morgan with it. Morgan, forward to number 17. That's Cole Mayer, and that's a goal! A very, very tight angle, but it's a goal for Union College, and like I said, they jinx it, they strike first.
And what a great goal there. I mean, taking the lead, you knew it was gonna happen, you knew it was gonna happen eventually. Pretty even, I mean, the great goal.
And so just like that, Union College striking first here against the number one team in the nation. That puck going out of bounds. We take a look at the replay. We had seen the replay earlier. It was a shot from number 25. Apologies, not able to mention who it was. It's the assistant captain, Ryan Walker. It was a very beautiful pass to Walker, who was wide open. He was able to convert. Just like that, the puck was behind the net. I thought it was, you know, going to be one of those pucks where it just cycles around, back around, but Walker made a nice play to get in front.
Walker's seventh goal on the year, 15th point. I mean, one of the senior leaders on this team, of course, the assistant captain. Great goal, gives Union the 1-0 lead. Again, if you're just joining us, my name's Logan Carney. I'm here with Spencer Witt. Thank you always for joining the RMU Athletics broadcast feeds.
Hey, those are my lines.
Well, I just wanted to thank everybody for joining us. Might as well, right?
Yeah, we've got over, I believe, last time I checked, it was about 560 people.
570 now watching on somehow YouTube. Of course, some on RMU Radio listening as well.
Of course.
Tonight's game will be between RMU and Brown, the second game of the Three Rivers Classic. We're at the UPMC Lemieux Center Sports Complex. I'm used to saying RMU Island Sports Center, but we're at the UPMC Lemieux Sports Complex for game one.
Yeah, so we've got over 570 people who decided to go on YouTube or RMU Radio and listen to us talk about Union College and St. Cloud State. St. Cloud State in front, that one off of Miller, but Miller is still with it. Or Walker, excuse me. This one is to Miller now, number 15. Miller behind the net, two players on him. He tries to drop it off to Jackson, where St. Cloud State pinching forward to help him out. Into the air right in front of the net. A blast there by Perbix. But it went wide. St. Cloud State's doing, or excuse me, Union College doing a really good job getting in front. And not letting Hansen have to deal with any pucks. Wrapping around, and that one just wide. It went into the crease there. But St. Cloud State was not able to push it forward. There was no stick in the area. And the one that did get there was just a little too late.
Now, you did jinx the no goals earlier in the game, but how about no penalties so far? Very clean game between, you know, two of the top teams.
That'll be a matter of about a minute, I think, before we jinx that one. Sapinski will send it all the way around. St. Cloud State will bounce it off their own boards and try and push it forward, but it goes into the netting, and play will stop with 2 minutes and 56 seconds remaining.
Union with the lead over the number one team in the country. Now, again, we talked about this. We've touched about this throughout the first period. St. Cloud State on the longest, you know, no lose, unbeaten streak. That's a better way to say it than no lose. In the country with 10 games so far, only one loss. Of course, that loss to Northeastern. Like we said, Northeastern lost to Union the week prior.
Player very slow to get up for St. Cloud State. That one in front and another goal. Union College, several players in front of the goaltender, and they get it by him. I believe it was Estes who gets the goal. A lot of traffic in front. Rennick probably couldn't see it, and it's the second goal of the game.
And just like that in the first period, two goals already higher than Rennick's goal against average.
So Brandon Estes, excuse me, my apologies on his name. I saw more traffic in front of that net than 376 during rush hour. And only Pittsburgh people are going to understand that one. Shot taken, that one deflects away. Newell with it, Newell. Four for St. Cloud State. So Union College coming in, 14th ranked in the nation. They want to move up a little bit in the standings. He's going to try and beat the number one team. They've got two goals, but still plenty of time for the Huskies to come back. Kolias, that one bouncing it off of a player and kept in by St. Cloud State.
Yeah, Union College in the USCHO pool is what we're referencing, number 14. They fell out of the USA Today poll for the first time this season. Back on December 17th, received 14 votes in that. The highest vote getter not ranked in the USA Today poll.
Saw a shot in front, was deflected away by number 26 for Union College. And he was slow to get off the ice. Josh Kosak, but looks to be all right. Several block shots for Union College. They did a good job getting in front of the puck. A minute, 18 seconds remaining in the first period. Kolias with it. Kolias pushing forward. Kept in by Union College. Almost a no-look pass, but no help for that. A minute remaining here in the first period. One's pushed away. St. Cloud State behind their own net. Look for maybe one more push forward. Bouncing around, and it will be no icing as the player was there for it for St. Cloud State. Now here comes the Dutchman. Big hit right there, the blue line. Drop back off for St. Cloud State. Final 20 seconds thrown towards Hansen, but he'll just push it away. Bouncing off the boards and going right back to Purbix. Purbix dropping it off to Ashawn. And back to Purbix. Miller pushing forward. Not able to get it to his line mate. And that will be the final 3 seconds left. And so just like that, it's two goals from Union College. Ryan Walker with the first one. Brandon Estes with the second, and the difference right now, it's 2-0 Union, but still two periods remaining. Once again, we thank you so much for tuning in. Do not go anywhere. Still two whole periods here on RMU Athletics and RMU Radio, your campus, your voice.
Can't get enough of your favorite Colonial sports? Follow RMU Athletics on social media at RMU Athletics on Twitter, RMU Athletics on Instagram, and be sure to like our page on Facebook at Robert Morris University Athletics. Go Colonials!
Hey there, Colonial fans. It's time to meet our Student Athletes of the Week, sponsored by People's Gas. This week, we celebrate Malik Padaway from men's basketball and Alex Tonge from men's hockey. Senior forward Malik Padaway finished up non-conference play with a double-double in the Colonials' huge blowout against Hood on Saturday, with 18 points and 10 rebounds. He shot .889 from the field, helping the Colonials achieve their second-highest field goal percentage in program history. Senior forward Alex Tonge scored two goals in the Colonials' 3-1 win over AIC on Sunday, with his 7th and 8th goals of the season. Tonja's game winner came just 8 seconds into the third period on a breakaway and puts him 6th place on the program's all-time scoring list. Congratulations to our Student Athletes of the Week. For more, visit rmucolonials.com and remember to use the hashtag ColonialPride.
Here at the Army Island Sports Center, I'm Matt Geica with head coach Derek Schooley. Time to talk pucks once again. It's the Men's Hockey Weekly, and an important week, coach, with the Three Rivers Classic coming up. But before we get to that, you come off the holiday break with a split at AIC up in Massachusetts. You score three goals in both of those games, too, against a second-place team. Feel like that's a pretty positive outcome to start the second half?
Well, I thought we were really good to open our first game. I thought we were really good, and as the game went on, I thought they took it to us a little bit. And in the third period, they were it was back to an even game again, and they got a bounce at the end, and we didn't get a penalty kill that we needed right down the stretch. And good hockey game, good first weekend out. We got a nice. I think we kind of stole the game with 17 shots on goal. Francis Murat was outstanding. I thought Luke Lynch and Alex Tonge were big-time leaders for us offensively, and a big-time play by the two of them and Eric Israel to get us the game-winning goal. So, you're always happy to go on the road and get a split, and we got to be ready to go here, and we got to continue to get better.
Yeah, this is different this week. Typically, with the Classic, it's right after the holiday. This time you get two games, maybe get your feet back under you in game action. Alex Tonge seemed to think on Sunday that was an advantage. How do you feel about it as a coach?
Well, it's a weird time because you got New Year's and New Year's Day and all thrown in the mix, and then we're coming back, and you've got some really quality teams coming in, and the Browns playing very well right now. They just beat Army. You got St. Cloud, number one in the nation, and then you got Union that's been consistent in the top 15 all year. So these are some good hockey teams that are coming into the Three Rivers Classic, so hopefully we can continue the success we've had in this tournament, because it's always fun for our guys, our student-athletes, and we're ready to go, hopefully.
Yeah, what's the energy like on a week like this? It's a short week, but like you said, it's one thing that you look forward to every year, no doubt about it, with this tournament.
Well, I think the energy is going to pick up as the week goes on. We've got the banquet, and the teams are going to start coming into town, and you're going to see Union practicing here at our rink and tomorrow, and then you got the banquet on Thursday. And so I think it's one of those things. I think as the week goes on, the energy is going to pick up, and we know this is always a big deal for our university and for us in the hockey community in the city of Pittsburgh. So I think the energy is going to get going, and we had a really good practice today, and we had a get our legs adjusted after a day off on New Year's Day. So tomorrow will be also a good day, and as I said, we'll get the energy cranked up as the weekend goes on.
You've won the Confluence Cup 3 out of 6 times this tournament has been competed. You've joked after a couple of the wins that it might be tough to get some quality teams in here because they're afraid of getting upset, but you did it again. You do have, like you mentioned, with Union and St. Cloud State, two ranked opponents, and Brown coming off a nice win. How much of a point of pride is that for you as a program to keep bringing these strong fields into Pittsburgh?
Well, you want to keep having these good exposing college hockey to people and the fans, and get top ranked teams coming in, and you never know where they're going to be ranked when you get them, but you always want to try to get teams that have great histories and have done very well. St. Cloud was number one in the nation last year going into the NCAA tournament, so you knew that they were going to have a strong team. Union's always been strong. They won the national championship. Brown's got the history and the pedigree of an Ivy League school, so you knew when we scheduled these that there'd be a chance for them to be good hockey teams, and here we are getting a top 15 team and a number one team in the nation.
Army will open up against Brown in the Classic up at the UPMC Lemieux Sports Complex in Cranberry. That'll be the nightcap on Friday, as it'll be St. Cloud State and Union at 5 o'clock, Colonials and Brown for the first time ever in the two teams' respective histories at 8, and then we'll see how things shake out for the consolation and the championship games at PPG Paints Arena on Saturday. For Coach Schooley, I'm Matt Geica. We'll talk to you next time.
Man, you've got a lot going on, and you're making it happen. But you still need to eat. You need takeout. Eaton Park is the answer. A huge menu that everyone can agree on, no matter what you're hungry for. Easy online ordering to get the order right and get it the way you want it. Plus, fast and easy pickup windows, so you can get your order and stay in your car. Eaton Park for takeout. Quick, easy, delicious.
Today you bought breakfast for your team using Apple Pay. Today you used Clearview's mobile app with Touch ID and Bill Payer to pay your bills, leaving you more time to train for that 5K. And today you used Mobile Deposit to safely deposit a check from home without a trip to a branch. At Clearview. Clearview Federal Credit Union. Technology that saves time, makes time for more important things. Clearview Federal Credit Union, the next generation of personal banking.
Here at the Army Island Sports Center, ready for the Three Rivers Classic. I'm Matt Geica, talking to senior captain Brandon Watt. And Brandon, a short week coming off the trip to AIC where you guys split. Do you feel like that's maybe a good thing because you can keep that momentum going?
Yeah, I mean, it was nice to get a couple of games in early as soon as we came back from break. Nice to get our legs under us, especially after we had a little bit of a longer break over Christmas this year. So, you know, usually like we play the Three Rivers as soon as we get back. So I think the trip to AAC definitely helped us get back and into the swing of things before we start the tourney.
I was talking to Alex Tonge after the Sunday game up there in Massachusetts. He said he thought it might be an advantage to get those two games and feel like you're back in the swing of things. Do you feel the same way?
Yeah, for sure. Like I said, in the past years we came back and those were the first games we've played, especially playing teams from out of conference. You know, it's always kind of a different game. So it was nice to get down to Springfield for a road trip and get a couple of games under us.
So far this season, including out there at Springfield, it's been a very successful defensive season for your team. It's a departure from what the Colonials are used to being about. Why do you think the D has been such a lockdown factor this year?
I think it all starts with our goalie, Frankie. You know, sometimes I think this year we haven't exactly found a way to score goals like we have in the past. So in order to win hockey games when you're not putting up, you know, 4 or 5 goals a game, it's playing sound defensively. And I think down the stretch it's certainly going to help us, you know, as long as we continue to find ways to score goals. I think our power play is starting to click a little bit more now. So the fact that we can bear down defensively will definitely help us down the stretch.
That's been a different type of a season for you, obviously, as team captain. That's an increased responsibility, but also you had some injuries to battle through too. So how do you feel where you're at emotionally, or have you kept your confidence up as now you're working your way back into things?
Yeah, I mean, it's kind of been the same way for the past 2 years for me, battling some injuries. But, you know, I think it's been good that the coaches have supported me the whole time, and, you know, teammates have helped me keep my confidence up. You know, kind of sad to say, but I guess I'm kind of used to it by now, you know, just working my way back in and trying to find my legs and whatnot, especially coming off an injury.
Now, last thing for you, the Three Rivers Classic, you've been on the winning side, and you've also seen another team hoist the Confluence Cup. How important is this weekend? Because it's right in the middle of the season, it's not Atlantic Hockey play, but you get a chance to put your skills and your team's ability on display for the entire nation, really.
I think it's cool. It's definitely a good experience for us. We get to play teams that, you know, we don't normally see, especially teams coming from out of conference. And I think it's also a huge turning point in the season, too. The first 2 years we were able to win, which was nice, and it kind of brought our team closer. And even last year we kind of learned a little bit about our team. And I think the past 3 years, this tournament really kind of defined who we were in terms of, you know, bringing us all together for the stretch drive.
Let's come see the Colonials. The Muse Sports Complex in Cranberry, 8 o'clock. They have the nightcap on Friday against Brown University, then St. Cloud State or Union the second day at PPG Paints Arena.
I was always fairly into education. I took it serious, and I'd always thought about the additional education, but I just never really thought I'd have the time to do it.
My dad and my brother got their MBA before I did, so they always said that they were in the master's club, and I wasn't in it. So then when I finished mine, Joe wasn't in the club, so he felt the need to join our club.
So I'm trying to balance this work and school and home life, and then we find out in October that we're expecting a baby. It's just going to be a whole new adventure and just a lot of exciting things going on in our life.
I went all over the country, 12 hospitals, 7 doctors, 6 bronchoscopies. No one could figure out what was wrong with me. I couldn't breathe. I couldn't make it from here to the door. Finally, the last doctor we saw told us to go to UPMC. That hospital saved my life. I can't explain how good it felt to unplug my chair. I have a real life back. I didn't choose to have severe asthma, but I did choose UPMC.
RMU Radio provides a space and opportunity for the entire RMU community to both use their voice and listen to the voices of others. We have a wide range of options for students to do their own talk shows, music shows, or can bring guests in and interview them on air. We are now broadcasting in Romo's, Wheatley and PNC Colonial Cafe. You can also listen to RMU Radio by downloading TuneIn app or redirecting to rmuradio.com.
Look at that in there. Look at those things. Those gym jackets, those are pretty cool, huh? You can go. Go ahead.
Move in.
What?
Stop. Oh my god!
Sam. Go look at those. Look at those things there. They're pretty cool. We're gonna use them. Yeah.
Yeah. Oh! Yeah, that was good.
That was good.
New
stuff there.
Yeah.
Oh, that's all. We're not having a meeting. Wanted to do a promo thing. Do you want to have a promo?
Yeah.
It's fine.
Yeah.
You can
see it. What if I lay down on this one?
Yeah, lay down on that one.
Okay, what am I doing now?
So you're just gonna hide from the box and then he's gonna get you that. Yeah.
He's gonna what?
Get like a
so then you just pop out.
So how should I pop out though?
Just like straight out.
Do you think I'm gonna fit in there? What about this box?
Can you try to get it?
I can for sure fit in there. Just try to get it.
We'll get you down that way. Well, we want to use the big box, but then it's like kind of obvious because we're laying down.
Yeah.
I try to fit in this one. I try to lay down.
Oh my god, dude!
Can't get enough of your favorite Colonial teams? Follow RMU Athletics on social media at RMU Athletics on Twitter, RMU Athletics on Instagram, and be sure to like our page on Facebook at Robert Morris University Athletics. Go Colonials!
Welcome back here on RMU Athletics YouTube live stream of the first game of the 2019 Three Rivers Classic between the St. Cloud State Huskies and the Union College Dutchmen. It's Union College that has two goals somewhat later in that first period. Both of them were from Ryan Walker and Brandon Estes. So those are the difference so far in this game. The number one team in the nation. A slow start for them, and they're down 2-0, and they'll have to try and come back. They'll have at least two periods to try and do that. Union College will look to try and push forward. We're back underway here in the second period. St. Cloud State with it. And they'll be going from right to left, and Union College now will be going from left to right. A blast there, and that one goes wide for number 10 for St. Cloud State. John Lazat. It wasn't even close to the net that much. Netminder Darian Hansen put his glove up, but nothing going for that one. Still fighting for it. Lazat with it, though. Lazat trying to get it off to one of his teammates, but it's deflected away. Good defense from number 17, Cole Meyer for Union College. Bouncing around. Adams was fighting for it. Fitzgerald will take it out. Behind the net, they'll wrap it back around to Fitzgerald. Fitzgerald will try and push it forward where a St. Cloud player gets a touch on it. So no icing, and it goes into the corner. That was Paling who got a piece of it. Parrix with a shot and blocked away again by Union College. Good defense up front there. That's Fu this time. Forward and Paling not able to get his stick on it. That was Nick Paling. It bounces back. Number 2 for Union College pushing forward now. That was Taylor Brierly. And on the forecheck, a couple players trying to get it out. Shot taken, but it's deflected away by a stick in front. That was Jackson who got a stick on it. Delayed offsides. In fact, it will be an offsides is the call as that puck went over the blue line, and so we'll have a face-off outside the zone.
You know, Spencer, the thing that's really stood out to me in this game, and we talked about in the first period, still no penalties.
Yeah.
22 minutes in now, as we get to 2 minutes into the second period, not a single penalty by either team in this game.
Of course, it's still been a very physical game. We've seen a lot of checks and some collisions, but again, everything clean.
Yeah, good, clean, physical hockey.
Trying to outrun that one was number 8 for Union College, Anthony Rinaldi, but instead it's called icing. So clock had stopped at 17:56. Once again here at the Lemieux Sports Complex. Practice facility of the Pittsburgh Penguins. 5-time Stanley Cup champions.
In Union right now, they lead 2-0, but they're down in shots 24-19. Now, Spencer, the last time Union won was while being outshot was back in November. November 24th against Boston University. They won 2-1 after being outshot 40-38.
Still, even then, they had 38 shots in that game.
78 total shots, only 3 total goals.
That's a... Give those goaltenders some credit. That's ones you hate to lose, too, especially you know, you give 2 goals. You stop 40 or 38 shots. That one off of a player for Union College. It'll go all the way back around to Campbell. Campbell with some pressure on him. He drops it back off, and he gets it back. A collision in open ice. 2 players. 1 player going down hard and slow to get up is number 17, Jacob Benson. Benson skating off his own power, but he's very slow off the ice. Surprised there's no call or anything. That's nowhere near the puck. Might have just been some incidental contact, but these referees, they're keeping their arms down. Like you said before, no penalties so far. Estes dropping it back off to Brierley. Brierley behind the net. A fake from the captain, Cole Meyer. And then Meyer pushing it forward past the red line. Goes off a couple players. And in the corner where it's brought out by Union College. Brierley with a shot. In front again, another shot. That one just bounced perfectly to Meyer. And Rennick was able to get his glove on it.
Great glove save there by Rennick.
So Rennick doing a good job. Their team's still down 2 goals in this second period. Into the corner. A shot taken by number 12. That was Ashawn. Oh, big hit there. Meyer and Ashawn colliding, and it looked like it was a forceful collision, but both of them stayed on their feet. Fitzgerald forward, not able to get far enough forward, so he tries to make a turn. It's taken right back by Union College, the Dutchman, but they're going to be offsides as Vidmar tried to go forward, and he was not allowed to do that. So 15 minutes and 8 seconds remaining in the second period.
So Spencer, I'm going to go back to this because this is very interesting. Still no penalties halfway through the game. Union, and since being a D1 team, they have never played in a game in which both teams did not register a penalty. I could not find the statistics on that for St. Cloud State, but you know, that just shows you just how rare, you know, a clean game like this. Union hasn't finished a game being penalized since 2014. Very rare, you know, to see a clean game like this.
Good stat right there since 2014.
Again, still a lot of hockey left.
Oh, plenty of hockey. Plenty of hockey for St. Cloud State to get back in this. Only down 2 goals, and like I've mentioned before, time in and time out, the hardest lead to hold in hockey is the 2-goal lead.
We also touched about this earlier. 2 Palings on St. Cloud State University.
Yeah.
Ryan Paling, not here. He also plays for St. Cloud State, but he's not here today. The Twin Palings obviously both playing. Ryan, his game just started. He's playing for Team USA against Russia right now in Vancouver for the World Juniors Championship.
That's crazy. Imagine having three Palings on your team. Oh, right in front, and a goaltender had to move forward for that one. That was Hansen, almost diving away to poke check that one forward. Morgan with a shot, and it's collected and kept by Rennick. So play will stop at 14 minutes and 20 seconds remaining. Once again, we thank you so much for tuning in here on RMU Athletics live stream and RMU Radio, your campus, your voice. I'm Spencer Witt, Logan Carney beside me. Both of us students at Robert Morris University. It's an honor to be able to do this here every year. Robert Morris always does a great job hosting this tournament. A little bit different this year. Not necessarily the level of competition different or anything like that, just the venue for the first game is different at the Lemieux Sports Complex. Faceoff taken by St. Cloud State. The Huskies are moving forward. And they're able to keep it in, but it goes off of a couple sticks. Still trying to keep it in. Newell. Newell with a shot. That one wide. The puck bounced perfectly to him, and he's able to get around one defender. But his shot went wide. Around in the corner, and it'll go all the way back where the captain will try and push it forward. Henkes with it. Henkes with a player on him. He'll just cycle it around the boards. Kept in by Newell. Newell tries to get around a defender. It's Estes. He's not able to. Stick goes away from number two, Brierley, and Brierley keeps with it, but a big hit on Estes. Behind the net. Adams touching it forward. Union College will change their lines. Puck behind the net for number 25. It's Nick Herbix. Oh, and for Fitzgerald. Fitzgerald looking to try and throw it in front, I believe, but he wasn't able to get to do that. Herbix with a drive, and that one bounces wide. Forward, touched by one player, and then I believe it's going to be an offsides. It will be. So an offsides on Union College. With 12 minutes and 48 seconds remaining, we'll take a quick timeout, immediate timeout. We'll take a quick timeout here at RMU Athletics on the YouTube channel of RMU Athletics, the home of Robert Morris Sports. Welcome back here on the RMU Athletics YouTube feed. 12 minutes and 48 seconds remaining. It was two goals by Union College in the first period that are the difference so far. Ryan Walker scored the first one. Brandon Estes scored the second. Union College wins this faceoff. We're back underway. St. Cloud State with it though. Ashawn. Ashawn forward. Taking that one shot, and it deflects off of a stick and into the netting. Play will stop with 12 and a half minutes remaining in the second period.
Yeah, Spencer, a little bit of a century mark watch for St. Cloud State. Three Huskies all within 10 points of joining the 100-point club. Of course, Patrick Newell, Robbie Jackson, and Jimmy Schultz all within 10 points of doing it. Robbie Jackson, 97 points, and Jimmy Schultz, 98 points. They can actually do it this weekend.
Jackson with a bit of a shot there, and it went wide. Rinaldi with it for Union College. Ashawn instead will take it. He gives it over to Perbix. Perbix, that one perfectly bouncing off of the wall, and it'll go all the way back down. No icing is the call. Having to move forward is Brierley. Brierley will push it forward. We'll go all the way around. Sapinski will try and get some forecheck on it. Paling with it, though. Paling, that one wide. It looked like trying to take a shot, trying to go to the far side on a nice angle to the left of the goaltender Hansen, but not able to get it anywhere near it. The captain with it for St. Cloud State. Henkes goes back to Fitzgerald. Paling, this is Jack Paling. Over to Nick Paling. Nick Paling, some pressure on him from Union College, taking a shot as he was falling down. Really good defense there from Josh Kosak. St. Cloud State with it. Schultz with a shot, and that one goes wide, hits the boards behind Hansen. A big hit into the boards as well. Union College able to push forward. 2-on-1. Sapinski not able to hold on to it. Schultz, I think he got a stick on it. Brzezinski. Over to number 19 for St. Cloud State. Bushy pushing it forward. That was Henkes, excuse me. Henkes will push it around to Bushy behind the net, where Union College gets a player on him, a player going down. The fans in the area were looking for maybe a call, but nothing called. Bushy with it, thrown in front. An opportunity, a man in front, bouncing around, and it goes wide, not able to get a stick on it. It was a St. Cloud State player, but a huge rebound and a wide open net. Just couldn't whack it out of the air. Play has stopped as it was an icing on the play.
You know, again, looking at some of these statistics, St. Cloud State starting to pull away with shots, 32 to 22. Of course, these statistics aren't fully updated. This is a couple minutes late. This is about 7 minutes. Oh, there we go. They just updated 34-22. Shots on goal, 14-13, though. So St. Cloud State, you're generating shots, but in terms of, you know, quality chances, just about as many as Union has.
34 shots in two periods. Not even two periods. Is that correct?
It's midway through the second period, 34 shots for St. Cloud State University. 14 of them on goal, though. Again, we have to go back to November for the last time Union won a game while being outshot. We talked about that earlier, the 78 shot game.
You gotta give the defense for Union College a lot of credit, though. The Dutchmen, they've done a good job getting in front of the puck. Hansen's done a good job seeing the puck. St. Cloud State, they're just not able to get everything on net. It seems like they've had some opportunities, but just not able to get it into the net. It's like we saw in that one replay earlier, Hansen having to like dive forward and chip it away. It's been, I would call it frustrating for St. Cloud State right now. You're down two goals. Controlled shot-wise by a large margin, but
I think a big miss is the loss of Paling, who of course is playing. We've talked about it throughout.
Yeah.
He's playing the World College Juniors today. He leads
World Junior,
St. Cloud
Junior,
State
yeah.
with 14 assists this season, so they're without their assist leader. Of course, there are still two Palings out there.
Two is better than one, and right now St. Cloud State has two of them out there. But what Union College has in two is goals. Is that puck bouncing around, and I believe Rennick had to get a piece of it. Trying to move forward. 3-on-2, a nice move there. In front, and save made by Rennick. What a save. Or excuse me, save made by Hansen. That one bouncing over. And it's kept in by St. Cloud. Open shot, Miller, and that one wide. I think a stick got on it. Union College doing everything they can right now to keep St. Cloud State off the scoreboard. Walker with it. Walker forward, Paling. Paling in front, and he was looking for some help, but not able to get a stick on that puck. Union moving forward. That one in front, and scores! It's number 22 for Union College. Parker Fu, who throws it right by the goaltender Rennick, and it's 3-0 Union College.
Parker Fu with his fourth goal of the season, the Chicago Blackhawk draftee. 3-0 Union College on the number one team in the country.
Fu doing an incredible job getting around the defender and just keep going. He's skating right by him. To the left side of the net, and a third goal for Union College. The 14th ranked team in the nation is up 3-0 on the number one team in the nation. The magic of the Three Rivers Classic.
It's Parker Fu with the goal, assisted by Cole Mayer.
And Union College are going to look forward again, trying to get around, wrapping it around in front, and that one is away from Rennick. Adams and Morton fighting for it for the Dutchman. Paling, that one bouncing off two players. St. Cloud State will regroup in their own zone. 8 minutes remaining in the second period. Fitzgerald. Forward, that one will go away from the St. Cloud State player. Into the corner, Wallen. Behind the net, wrapping it around and deflected away by Hansen. Still in the corner, about five players over there to try and fight for that puck. Brought up by Estes. Taken back, stolen away by St. Cloud State. Number 17. Them is fighting for it. That's Jacob Benson, and there's at least two other players over there as well. Referee looking at it. Puck's still moving, so of course nothing has been stopped yet.
So we talked about, you know, the way Union has played. They've given up 37 shots, but defensively only 16 of them on goal. They played very good defensively and not given up the chances that St. Cloud State would need to get on the board.
Puck finally comes out, and it went all the way back down. And we'll have a face-off all the way down in Union College's side. To the right side of Darian Hansen.
Yeah, Union doing a great job, a better job than St. Cloud State is at capitalizing on their chances. Of course, obviously, with a three-goal lead, you look at all the other statistics, it's all pretty even. You know, faceoffs still evenly split. You know, shots on goal, both teams with 16. It's just Union has done a better job at being able to take advantage of the chances that they've been given.
Rinaldi with it in the corner for Union College. In front, nobody there for it though. Taken by St. Cloud State, they'll move forward. Player trying to get on it. It goes outside the lines, and so it will be an offsides on the play. 6 minutes and 9 seconds remaining here. Once again, we thank you so much for tuning in to our live stream on YouTube. The first game of the Three Rivers Classic between Union College and St. Cloud State. Of course, stay tuned. After this, at 8 o'clock, pending anything overtime or anything like that, Robert Morris will be taking on Brown in the second game of Three Rivers Classic. Winner of this game will go on to the championship tomorrow night at 8 o'clock at PPG Paints Arena. And the second place of this game will be fighting for third place overall in the tournament at 5 o'clock tomorrow at PPG Paints Arena.
And Spencer, I think we forgot to give a shout-out in the first period to Brendan Estes, who tied his career high in points in the first period with an assist and a goal, his career high of two. Which didn't happen too long ago, actually happened at the end of December against Kinesis. So Brandon Estes tying his career high. He did it in the first period, of course, and we're in the second period now. There's just 6 minutes left. Union 3-0 on the number one team in the country.
Yeah, congratulations to Estes. Union College, I mean, a good team here. 9-4-4 record overall. They beat Northeastern. You know, we talked about common opponents. Northeastern, the only team to beat St. Cloud State coming into today. Union College beat them not once, but twice early on in the season.
And the weekend before, they would go, Northeastern would beat St. Cloud State too, so. We're talking about common opponents. You can't get more common than that.
Koulias will have to come all the way back down and get the puck in his own zone. Goes back to Koulias. Koulias forward. Sapinski. A couple defenders converge on him, and he's not able to move with the puck. And offsides is the call. The linesman calling that one offsides. At 5 minutes and 19 seconds remaining. Media timeout. We'll take a quick timeout here on our YouTube live stream at RMU Athletics and RMU Radio, your campus, your voice.
Man, you've got a lot going on, and you're making it happen. But you still need to eat. You need takeout. Eaton Park is the answer. A huge menu that everyone can agree on, no matter what you're hungry for. Easy online ordering to get the order right and get it the way you want it. Plus, fast and easy pickup windows, so you can get your order and stay in your car. Eaton Park for takeout. Quick, easy, delicious.
Can't get enough of your favorite Colonial teams? Follow RMU Athletics on social media at RMU Athletics on Twitter, RMU Athletics on Instagram, and be sure to like our page on Facebook at Robert Morris University Athletics. Go Colonials!
Welcome back here on a live stream, RMU Athletics and RMU Radio, your campus, your voice. I'm Spencer Witt, Logan Carney beside me, and been a good one so far. Union College, 3 goals against the number one team in the nation. I saw a commenter on YouTube said before, another slow start for St. Cloud State. But more or less, they have yet to get started on the goal sheet. Right now, so far a shutout for Darian Hansen. Still a whole nother period to play, though. And anything can happen in the third period.
Yeah, Union's last shutout took place earlier this year against another Three Rivers Classic team, Brown University. Took place back in December. December 20th, 2-0 win against Brown.
Not too long ago.
Of course, Brown going to be taking on RMU later tonight.
We'll hear that game later on, 8 o'clock. Here's the puck drop for that one. Right now, Union College, 3 goals against St. Cloud State. The Huskies are going to try and get something on the board here to get themselves a bit of a comeback, and it'll be, I believe, an icing call on the play.
So Spencer, probably the cleanest game that you and I have seen. I mean, we've been talking about it all throughout. Still not one penalty left in this game for either team.
Yeah, not necessarily used to that. We are, but both of these teams doing a good job, I think, keeping it clean, but a very physical game. Face-off won by St. Cloud State. Bushy, that one thrown in front, bouncing around. Opportunity on the rebound. Still in front. Where's the puck? It goes all the way back out past the blue line.
And that was a great job there by Union to not give up a goal. It was very threatening by the number one team in the country, St. Cloud State.
That pass almost dropped off to Miller. Miller going down. And hey, we jinxed it. There is the first penalty of the evening. It's going to go on number 20 for Union College. That's Greg Campbell, excuse me. And so St. Cloud State, first power play opportunity of the evening.
Yes, we did jinx it indeed. That's the first penalty of the game. 3:54 remaining in the second period. So
Greg Campbell goes to the box for tripping and a big opportunity for the Huskies. See how they do on the power play, and we'll see how Union College does on the penalty kill. Faceoff won by the Huskies, but that one goes past the blue line, so they'll have to come back a little bit. 2:16:06. Newell with it for St. Cloud State. He'll move forward, dropping off to his teammate, thrown in front. Newell almost had a rebound there. He was just kind of trailing the play. Would have been a tough angle to get it in, but wasn't able to keep the puck on his stick anyway. Jackson with it. Jackson behind the boards. Back to Newell. At the point for the captain, Mayer. Or excuse me, Schultz. In front. Opportunity. They score. It's Fitzgerald. A tough angle and a nice fake. And the first goal for St. Cloud State. They come back on the power play.
And that was a much needed goal there. They couldn't afford to let that power play be killed. 3-1 now. Two-goal lead for Union. Still, two-goal lead. Little over one period left in the game. 3 minutes left in this second period.
Kevin Fitzgerald, his eighth goal of the season. And the Huskies slowly chipping away at this lead. And they're on the board. On a big opportunity, like I said, in the power play, and they're able to convert. The Dutchmen win the faceoff, and they'll try and push forward. Rennick just pushing it forward himself, and it goes away past the blue line. Wallen, excuse me, go ahead.
I was just going to say that St. Cloud State, of course, we all know they only have one loss in the year, but six times they have let their opponent score first, and six times they have come back and won the game.
Paling with it. They'll look to try and make it seven comebacks this year. That one bounces forward for Walker. Walker will just send it all the way down. There, Rennick will have to drop it off to Ashawn. Ashawn's a pressure on him. It bounces off the boards and not kept in play. It's going to be a delayed offside, so Union College will have to go back and get themselves back on sides. Oh, two players colliding. Right at the red line there, no call. Opportunity for Mayer. Mayer, two on one, then they score! Sebastian Vidmar, a beautiful pass from Mayer. And Union College scores again, their fourth goal of the game.
And this a strong goal there by Mayer to get it back within a minute, or within 2 minutes, my apologies, 2:01 left.
A beautiful pass, especially from Cole Mayer, dropping it off to his left side where Vidmar had no defenders on him. He's able to put it into the back of the net. And Union College gets their three-goal lead back. Big hit from St. Cloud State off the faceoff. The Huskies, after scoring, giving up an unfortunate goal for them. Union College, again, still keeping a three-goal lead as we approach a minute and a half remaining in the second period.
The St. Cloud power play.
In St. Cloud State, their opponent's game high against them. Five goals. Took all the way back in October 26. I'm sorry, that's Union I'm looking at, but Union, their highest five goals as well. That's what I was looking at back in December 29th. They've done that three times this year.
Oh, beautiful pass and a great block in front. From number two for Union, that's Taylor Brierly. Another shot deflected away. Brodzinski was the one who took the shot for the Huskies. 1 minute remaining in the second period. Brodzinski behind the net. Some pressure on him. Player all over him, and then another Dutchman coming over to help. Still in play, though, for the Huskies. Walker over to Miller. Miller has Campbell on him. Miller throwing it in front, tough angle, and it went off the side of the net. The Dutchman moving forward, that one bouncing off, and they were not able to go over the red line, so it's an icing call on the play. A big mistake there on an icing. 31 seconds remaining in the second period.
31 seconds remaining. 3-goal lead still for number 14 Union.
Face off. Battling for both teams, still in the zone. Kept in by St. Cloud State, but it's passed right back, or it's taken away, excuse me, by a Dutchman. Paling, oh, big hit from number 13. Emailophone, nice shoulder right into Paling. Another icing call with 5 seconds remaining in the second period. 4-1 is the score currently.
4-1 the score. St. Cloud State, 42 shots in this game. Just 2 periods, only 1 goal to show for it. Union doing a great job defensively. Only 20 of those 42 shots were on goal, as opposed to Union, 17 of their 24 on goal.
Seems like a very generous stat sheet there, given a lot of shots for St. Cloud State, but shots don't matter. What matters is goals, and Union College has 4 of them. Both teams scoring in the period. Union College, though, scoring twice. St. Cloud State only scoring once, and that's the difference right now. 4-1 as we approach the potentially final period of play. Do not go anywhere. Still a whole third period. St. Cloud State looking to come back, but Union College up 4-1 here on RMU Athletics and on RMU Radio, your campus, your voice.
Can't get enough of your favorite Colonial sports? Follow RMU Athletics on social media at RMU Athletics on Twitter, RMU Athletics on Instagram, and be sure to like our page on Facebook at Robert Morris University Athletics. Go Colonials!
Hey there, Colonial fans! It's time to meet our Student Athletes of the Week, sponsored by People's Gas. This week, we celebrate Malik Padaway from men's basketball and Alex Tonge from men's hockey. Senior forward Malik Padaway finished up non-conference play with a double-double in the Colonials' huge blowout against Hood on Saturday, with 18 points and 10 rebounds. He shot .889 from the field, helping the Colonials achieve their second highest field goal percentage in program history. Senior forward Alex Tonge scored 2 goals in the Colonials' 3-1 win over AIC on Sunday, with his 7th and 8th goals of the season. Tonja's game winner came just 8 seconds into the third period on a breakaway and puts him 6th place on the program's all-time scoring list. Congratulations to our Student Athletes of the Week. For more, visit rmucolonials.com and remember to use the hashtag ColonialPride.
Here at the Army Island Sports Center, I'm Matt Geica with head coach Derek Schooley. Time to talk pucks once again. It's the Men's Hockey Weekly and an important week, coach, with the Three Rivers Classic coming up. But before we get to that, you come off the holiday break with a split at AIC up in Massachusetts. You scored 3 goals in both of those games, too, against a second-place team. Feel like that's a pretty positive outcome to start the second half?
Well, I thought we were really good to open our first game. I thought we were really good, and as the game went on, I thought they took it to us a little bit. And then in the third period, they were it was back to an even game again, and they got a bounce at the end, and we didn't get a penalty kill that we needed right down the stretch. And good hockey game, good first weekend out. We got a nice... I think we kind of stole the game with 17 shots on goal. Francis Murat was outstanding. I thought Luke Lynch and Alex Tonge were big-time leaders for us offensively, and big-time play by the two of them and Eric Israel to get us the game-winning goal. So, yeah, you're always happy to go on the road and get a split, and we got to be ready to go here, and we got to continue to get better.
Yeah, this is different this week. Typically, with the Classic, it's right after the holiday. This time you get 2 games, maybe get your feet back under you in game action. Alex Tonge seemed to think on Sunday that was an advantage. How do you feel about it as a coach?
Well, it's a weird time because you got New Year's and New Year's Day and all thrown in the mix, and then we're coming back, and you've got some really quality teams coming in, and Brown's playing very well right now. They just beat Army. You got St. Cloud, number 1 in the nation, and then you got Union that's been consistently in the top 15 all year. So these are some good hockey teams that are coming into the Three Rivers Classic, so hopefully we can continue the success we've had in this tournament, because it's always fun for our guys, our student athletes, and we're ready to go, hopefully.
Yeah, what's the energy like on a week like this? It's a short week, but like you said, it's one thing that you look forward to every year, no doubt about it, with this tournament.
Well, I think the energy is going to pick up as the week goes on. We've got the banquet, and the teams are going to start coming into town, and you're going to see Union practicing here at our rink and tomorrow, and then you got the banquet on Thursday. And so I think it's one of those things. I think as the week goes on, the energy is going to pick up, and we know this is always a big deal for our university and for us in the hockey community in the city of Pittsburgh. So I think the energy is going to get going, and we had a really good practice today, and we had a get our legs adjusted after a day off on New Year's Day. So it tomorrow will be also a good day, and as I said, we'll get the energy cranked up as the weekend goes on.
You've won the Confluence Cup 3 out of 6 times. This tournament has been competed. You've joked after a couple of the wins that it might be tough to get some quality teams in here because they're afraid of getting upset, but you did it again. You do have, like you mentioned, with Union and St. Cloud State, 2 ranked opponents, and Brown coming off a nice win. How much of a point of pride is that for you as a program to keep bringing these strong fields into Pittsburgh?
Well, you want to keep having these good exposing college hockey to people and the fans, and get top ranked teams coming in, and you never know where they're going to be ranked when you get them, but you always want to try to get teams that have great histories and have done very well. St. Cloud was number 1 in the nation last year going into the NCAA tournament, so you knew that they were going to have a strong team. Union's always been strong. They won the national championship. Brown's got the history and the pedigree of an Ivy League school, so you knew when we scheduled these that there'd be a chance for them to be good hockey teams, and here we are getting a top 15 team and a number 1 team in the nation.
RMU will open up against Brown in the Classic up at the UPMC Lemieux Sports Complex in Cranberry. That'll be the nightcap on Friday, as it'll be St. Cloud State and Union at 5 o'clock, Colonials and Brown for the first time ever in the two teams' respective histories at 8, and then we'll see how things shake out for the Consolation and the Championship games at PPG Paints Arena on Saturday. For Coach Schooley, I'm Matt Geica. We'll talk to you next time.
Man, you've got a lot going on, and you're making it happen, but you still need to eat. You need takeout. Eaton Park is the answer. A huge menu that everyone can agree on, no matter what you're hungry for. Easy online ordering to get the order right and get it the way you want it. Plus, fast and easy pickup windows, so you can get your order and stay in your car. Eaton Park for takeout. Quick, easy, delicious.
Today you bought breakfast for your team using Apple Pay. Today you used Clearview's mobile app with Touch ID and Bill Payer to pay your bills, leaving you more time to train for that 5K. And today you used Mobile Deposit to safely deposit a check from home without a trip to a branch. At Clearview Federal Credit Union, technology that saves time makes time for more important things. Clearview Federal Credit Union, the next generation of personal banking.
At the Army Island Sports Center, ready for the Three Rivers Classic. I'm Matt Geica, talking to senior captain Brandon Watt. And Brandon, a short week coming off the trip to AIC where you guys split. Do you feel like that's maybe a good thing because you can keep that momentum going?
Yeah, I mean, it was nice to get a couple games in early as soon as we came back from break. Nice to get our legs under us, especially after we had a little bit of a longer break over Christmas this year. So, you know, usually like we play the Three Rivers as soon as we get back. So I think the trip to AAC definitely helped us get back and into the swing of things before we start the tourney.
I was talking to Alex Tonge after the Sunday game up there in Massachusetts. He said he thought it might be an advantage to get those 2 games and feel like you're back in the swing of things. Do you feel the same way?
Yeah, for sure. Like I said, in the past years we came back and those were the first games we've played. Especially playing teams from out of conference, you know, it's always kind of a different game. So it was nice to get down to Springfield for a road trip and get a couple of games under us.
So far this season, including out there at Springfield, it's been a very successful defensive season for your team. It's a departure from what the Colonials are used to being about. Why do you think the D has been such a lockdown factor this year?
I think it all starts with our goalie, Frankie. You know, sometimes I think this year we haven't exactly found a way to score goals like we have in the past. So in order to win hockey games when you're not putting up, you know, 4 or 5 goals a game, it's playing sound defensively. And I think down the stretch it's certainly going to help us you know, as long as we continue to find ways to score goals. I think our power play is starting to click a little bit more now. So the fact that we can bear down defensively will definitely help us down the stretch.
That's been a different type of a season for you, obviously, as team captain. that's an increased responsibility. But also you had some injuries to battle through too. So how do you feel where you're at emotionally, or have you kept it on display for the entire nation, really?
I think it's cool. It's definitely a good experience for us. We get to play teams that, you know, we don't normally see, especially teams coming from out of conference. And I think it's also a huge turning point this season, too. The first 2 years we were able to win, which was nice, and it kind of brought our team closer. And even last year we kind of learned a little bit about our team. And I think the past 3 years, this tournament really kind of defined who we were in terms of, you know, bringing us all together for the stretch drive.
So come see the Colonials. The Muse Sports Complex in Cranberry, 8 o'clock. They have the nightcap on Friday against Brown University, then St. Cloud State or Union the second day at PPG Paints Arena.
I was always fairly into education. I took it serious, and I'd always thought about the additional education, but I just never really thought I'd have the time to do it.
My dad and my brother got their MBA before I did, so they always said that they were in the master's club, and I wasn't in it. So then when I finished mine, Joe wasn't in the club, so he felt the need to join our club.
So I'm trying to balance this work and school and home life, and then we find out in October that we're expecting a baby. It's just going to be a whole new adventure and just a lot of exciting things going on in our life.
I went all over the country, 12 hospitals, 7 doctors, 6 bronchoscopies. No one could figure out what was wrong with me. I couldn't breathe. I couldn't make it from here to the door. Finally, the last doctor we saw told us to go to UPMC. That hospital saved my life. I can't explain how good it felt to unplug my chair. I have a real life back. I didn't choose to have severe asthma, but I did choose UPMC.
Your favorite Colonial teams? Follow RMU Athletics on social media at RMU Athletics on Twitter, RMU Athletics on Instagram, and be sure to like our page on Facebook at Robert Morris University Athletics. Go Colonials!
here on RMU Athletics. RMU Radio, your campus, your voice. Union College, 14th ranked in the nation. 4-1 on the number one team in the nation. St. Cloud State, the Huskies, they need 3 goals at least to try and get themselves back into this game and potentially win it. Remember, the winner goes on to the championship game of the Three Rivers Classic. We're back underway. And here's the third and final period.
Spencer, speaking of winners moving on, a big shout out to St. Cloud State player Ryan Paling with Team USA as they move on in the World Juniors as they defeated Russia 2-1. They'll take on either Finland or Switzerland in the goal for the goal game tomorrow.
Scoring again is Union College, and it's number 7 this time. Brandon Estes, another goal for him. 5-1 Union College.
And Estes, that's his career high now in points with his second goal of the game. 3 points for him. Of course, he had the assist in the first goal. 5-1. Didn't even get done speaking about the Team USA game. And 30 seconds into the third period, Union came out firing. This is their highest 2 of their season. It ties, as I mentioned earlier, a 5-goal game that they had back in October. I'm sorry, this ties a couple 5-goal games that they had. The last one against Canisius back in December 29th. But the fourth time that they scored 5 goals in the game, that is their season high. And they've done it today against the number one team in the country.
Oh, a big hit in the boards from St. Cloud State. Some fury there. What a save! Oh my goodness! Hansen on his back makes the catch. Unbelievable! Highway robbery!
Yeah, and after that, a little bit of extracurricular activities between the two teams. Number 19, Brendan Taylor, getting in with it with Jack Paling.
St. Cloud State thought they had a goal, but Hansen denying the Huskies. My goodness. One of the best saves we might see all weekend, and it's only the first game.
And he has been lights out tonight.
The Union goal was scored at 7.
No, Union put up 5 goals, but the big reason that they are leading the number one team in the country is that man right there.
And it bounces in again. This one deflects off one stick and it goes to number 27 for Union, Sebastian Vidmar, who scores. It's 6-1.
Well, I just said, you know Union has 5 goals. Now you know Union has 6 goals. Their highest goal total of the season. And they've done it against the number one team in the country.
6 goals against Union, and here comes Rennick. He has been pulled from the game. Jake Kupski will come in for St. Cloud State. It's a weekend so far, a Friday night, that the Huskies don't want to remember.
And Rennick, his goals against average has been tripled, more than tripled, against Union. His goals against 1.816 in this game.
Kupski makes the save there, routine glove save for him. As he checks into the game, his first shot against him is a routine save. 18 minutes and 21 seconds remaining.
We're on 2 minutes into the third period.
My apologies, I had wrenched in the wrong number one. Both these teams have 34-1 as their goaltenders. It's Jeff Smith who's in the game. Is that puck right on the side of the net, fighting for it, and it's covered up by Hansen. My apologies, Rennick coming out of the game. It's Jeff Smith, the senior, who's only played a couple games this year, 5 games on the win-loss and tie category, a 1.78 goals against average so far, but he was the netminder in that one loss.
And a .929 save percentage in those 5 games. So Spencer, yes, he has only played 5 games, but he's played very well in those 5 games.
Of course, Renick was 10-0 coming into this game, 10-0-1. So right now, it's Union College. You gotta give him credit, just all around doing a great job so far. Plenty of time. I'm not gonna necessarily say I've seen crazier, but I've seen a lot of crazy things when it comes to RMU athletics, and St. Cloud State's gotta be the same here. They're down 5 goals, but they're gonna need some help, and they're gonna have to go and score soon. That one covered up by Hansen.
And you can see the emotions starting to get to St. Cloud State, the number one team in the country.
Yeah.
We haven't seen this all game. Players, you know, talking to each other, players going after each other after the whistle. Just starting to see that now. The 6-1 deficit starting to get to St. Cloud State.
And only one penalty so far, but the way this game is going, I expect maybe some more. Of course, St. Cloud State did score on that one power play opportunity. The Huskies win the faceoff. That shot taken, thrown in front, bouncing around. And it's deflected away by Brierley. He whacked it out of the air, Brierley, and he gets his stick on it, but it's thrown in front again. Another shot, save made. Still bouncing around, and it's in the back of the net. Fitzgerald, I believe, was the one who got his stick on it. 6-2, the Huskies are able to score. And like I said before, they need to score early, and they did just that to try and chip away at this lead.
Can never count out the number one team in the country. We talked about it. They're number one for a reason. 6-0 when their opponents have scored first. Of course, they haven't faced a deficit like this year. But you can never count out the number one team in the country. 6-2 now.
I want to bounce all the way back down on the faceoff to Hansen. Union College will stay behind their net and they'll move forward. Kolias to Feynman. Feynman, excuse me, and I believe it actually will be an icing or an offside. Couldn't tell. There was a Brown player warming up right in front of me, so I didn't see what it was. I believe it was icing.
Union. You got to be happy if you're Union. This is the best game that they have played all year against the number one team in the country.
That shot going wide. There were a couple players in front of the net. In front for St. Cloud State. The player's just trying to get a piece of the puck. Bushy with it. Bushy over to Henkes. Matt Meyer. That one deflecting away. Brodzinski. Newell. Newell with it. That one whacked away by a player for Union College. Going across ice, nobody there. But Brodzinski is. Henkes, Brodzinski. Back to Bushy. Bushy throwing it in front. It's deflected away by Vidmar. Falling over, but they are able to get it out, is Union College.
The St. Cloud State goal was scored number 28, Kevin Fitzgerald.
So St. Cloud State with it, 15 minutes, 41 seconds. Fu with it. Fu had a goal earlier in the game. Goes all the way back down to Schultz. Schultz forward for Wallen. Wallen will send it all the way back. Campbell will have to get to it. He's got some pressure on him. Along with Estes. Huskies and Dutchman fighting for it. Benson. Benson right by the PPG sign right there. Of course, both these teams will play at PPG Paints Arena tomorrow. That one deflecting away. Number 55, Mika Ilyavin was the one who was there. Fu with it. Fu trying to get a blaster, but a good defensive play from number 10 for St. Cloud State. That was John Lazotte. 14:39. Walker with it. Walker coming around, and that one goes wide. Nobody there to help him out on the wraparound. Two-on-one opportunity for Union College. Throwing it in front, flicking at it, and it goes just by, and it's into the back of the net. Bouncing in the air right by the crease. And another goal for Union College. I believe it was Liam Morgan who scored this time. It was, and so it'll be a 7-2 game.
Yeah, and a lot of the people here pretty stunned by what's happening. I just saw a player for Brown almost chuckle to himself as he walked past. Couldn't believe that the number one team in the country down 5 goals to Union right now. Union, great team, number 14 in the country. You know, we talked about how they should never be counted out again in a game like this. Last time they've beaten the number one opponent was against St. Cloud State.
Now you got to give Union College credit. They're doing everything right now. Impressive saves from Hansen. Some great goals from several players. Another opportunity. Throwing that one in front, getting taken down, and a penalty, I believe, is going to... No, that's dislodged. Correction, no penalty. Just the net being dislodged was the call. I thought maybe he got pulled over, but some extracurricular activities after the play. Rinaldi talking things over with Jack Paling, asking each other how their new year was.
How was your new year, Spencer?
It was great. How was your new year?
It was great as well.
We're not as angry as they are in asking it. Immediate timeout. We'll go to a quick timeout as well. Union College, 7 goals. St. Cloud State, 2 goals. 13 minutes and 45 seconds remaining here on RMU Athletics and RMU Radio, your campus, your voice.
Spencer, you're talking about we call ourselves making a couple mistakes there.
Yeah, I had missed that one. I had mentioned Jake Kupski, but Jake Kupski not playing right now. He's currently sitting on the bench because Darian Hansen has done a great job in goal. That one's thrown all the way back around. Ryan Walker actually got credit for the goal. It was bouncing in the air. I'm not sure. I didn't know if Liam Morgan had touched it or not. But they gave Walker credit. Cole Meyer and Liam Morgan getting credit for the assists on the play. The PA announcer, Larry Snyder, announcing that Ryan Walker gets the goal.
You know, a hard hit there.
Some we heard it all afterwards, the too. Brodzinski was not a fan of that hit from Zachary Emailophone.
You know, Spencer, I mean, you talked about how, you know, Union doing everything right. We'll go back to the shots for St. Cloud State. 50 of them, 12 of them have been blocked, 24 saves made by that man in net right there.
Tough game for St. Cloud State as we saw a player falling over there. Schult with a Schult in front. Goaltender stick is gone. Still in front, and it bounces away. As I believe that was Fu who got a stick on it to push it forward. St. Cloud State in their own zone. Trying to get it out, and they will momentarily. Fu pushing it forward. And deflecting it is Jeff Smith, who just turns it to the side. And St. Cloud State will move forward. Benson crossing the blue line. Deflects off a stick. behind the net. Benson still fighting for it. Taken out and put into the air by 25, Walker. Perbix to Walker. Walker with a shot. Save made by Hansen. Over to Perbix. Perbix was looking for one of his players. Jackson for some help, wasn't able to get it to him. Perbix still with it, fighting with Walker, and Walker is the eventual winner, but not entirely. It goes to the other Walker. Both teams have a Walker, by the way. They haven't been on the ice both at the same time too many times, but right there they were. St. Cloud State's Walker was fighting Feinman for it. Feinman was able to flick it forward. Vidmar. Vidmar just out of the reach of Rinaldi, and Rinaldi wasn't able to push it forward. St. Cloud State with it. That shot taken, I believe it got deflected away by Estes. Noski's pinching forward, so Vidmar will take it. Vidmar over to Rinaldi. In front, off the post. A ringer for Union. Chip forward, opportunity falling over is Paling. Nothing called.
And Spencer, the 7 goals by Union tonight, the most that they have scored in a game since February 11th, 2017. They scored 8 against Dartmouth. So all of last season and this season, they have not put up the offensive performance that they have tonight. And of course, there's a big difference between the opponent that they played today and the opponent that they played back then. Number one team in the country today and putting up their highest goal total since February 11th of 2 years ago.
Of course, can't discredit Dartmouth, but like you mentioned, everything going right for Union. Forward, flicking that one towards the goal was number 7, Nick Paling, but not able to do much with it. A big hit from Kostak on Jaycox. Union College kind of summing up the game right there. Very physical hit in a game that, like I mentioned before, if it stays the same, the Huskies are not going to want to remember this one. Faceoff will be outside of the zone. Head near the GNC logo near the Dutchman bench. So 9 minutes and 24 seconds remaining, like we mentioned before. Almost 7 o'clock here local time. Potentially at 8 o'clock. We don't know if that'll change or not due to the game kind of stretching a little bit here. Robert Morris will take on Brown in the second game of the Three Rivers Classic. Do not want to miss that one as well. Once again, if everything holds up, Union College will play at 8 o'clock tomorrow at PPG Paints Arena, the home of the Pittsburgh Penguins. St. Cloud State will play in the 5 o'clock game tomorrow.
Assuming
everything holds. Yeah, taking a look at some of these replays, and Hanson has done a really, really good job so far. Just that one goal bouncing around a couple times, nothing he could do. Players in front, he just couldn't see it at all. He's done a good job, and Renica, tough one for him, the Slovakian native. A game he'll want to forget and get out of his memory for tomorrow and for games to come.
Yes, and you know, I said the very beginning of this game, 2 minutes in, St. Cloud State playing like the number one team in the country. Well, Union right now, this whole game, playing like they should be the number one team in the country.
Yeah.
7-2, phenomenal game across the whole board.
Oh, but a bad pass there right in front of the crease. But Hansen's able to cover it up.
Hansen getting them out of a little bit of trouble there. He was able to cover up the puck. Of course, he's had a great game. Big reason. We've talked about it all throughout this period. Big reason that they're up 7-2 is that man in net, Hansen.
That one pushed forward by Union College. Morgan with it. Morgan around behind the net, taken by the Huskies. Newell dropping that one off. Shot taken, stopped, not covered up yet until Hansen is able to cover it up.
8:51 remaining in the third period.
Face off to the right of Darian Hansen. Estes with the puck. Kolius, and then forward for Union College. Nice pass here for Vidmar. Vidmar unable to hold on to it. Towards the goal, but gets deflected away. Kolius. Union College, Vidmar with it. Vidmar crossing the blue line. Shot taken, it goes wide. 8 minutes and 10 seconds remaining in the third period. Tip forward to Benson, nice pass, cross ice. Benson with it, stopping. But some fighting right in front of the bench. Two players not happy with each other. It's 26 and 21, they're both gonna go to the box. Like some punches might have been thrown there. 21 for St. Cloud State, Jake Wallen. 26 for Union College, Josh Kosak.
Yeah, we talked about it again. Games are getting a little bit of chippy as Union started to pull away earlier in this period.
We saw Meyer also go into the bench there. I believe that was Meyer, Spencer Meyer, number 9 for St. Cloud State, going to the penalty box, excuse me. They're gonna pull him out, actually.
Very different type of game that we saw, you know, from the first two periods, when one penalty in the first two periods, game started to get a little bit chippy here. Of course, still very low on that penalty number.
The ref's talking things over.
They're trying to figure out who was involved in the scuffle, it looks like.
And away from the play, right in front of St. Cloud State's bench.
Great game played by Union, though. We talked about it. This whole period, 7-2 right now. Great game all around. Union only penalized once. Of course, St. Cloud State penalized no times, you know, depending on the outcome of what we're seeing here. Very good game by both teams. Union.
Mentioned real quick here, St. Cloud State number 9 on the board right now for a 5-minute major, Spencer Meyer. So Meyer with a 5-minute major. And that's the difference right now, is St. Cloud State only 4 guys on the ice. And, you know, an opportunity for Union to advance, score some more goals.
Spencer, I may have jinxed them a little bit with talking about the lack of penalties throughout the game.
Well,
I mean,
you knew this game was going to get a little bit, you know, more physical and frustrating. Is that shot taken? I believe that was Fu, Parker Fu. Goes all the way back down.
But still,
by Meyer.
But still, overall, as a game, these. Very, very clean game from both teams. Union, though, do everything right, and that's the big reason for that 7-2 lead, especially defensively.
Rinaldi not able to keep that one in. It'll go all the way back down. Tracking that one down is Hansen, and Hansen will have to bounce it off the boards to Ryan. Ryan sends it all the way back around. to number 28 for Union College, Sam Morton. Morton forward. Off the board, 6.5 minutes remaining. Morton keeping it in. Tipped forward though by St. Cloud State. Fitzgerald touching that one forward. Estes will come back. And the Dutchman will regroup. Brandon Estes. Sapinski. Physical there. He's number 6, Luke Jaycox, for St. Cloud State. Sapinski with it. Sapinski looking for a teammate there, not able to get it to him. Sent all the way back down the ice.
Now guarding the St. Cloud Jaycox, number 21, Jake Wallen. 2 minutes for hitting out of the whistle. Also serving the St. Cloud Jaycox, number 9, Spencer Meyer. A 5-minute penalty for fake pass.
Approaching the 5-minute mark left in the game. Is there announcing a...
Yeah, so Spencer Meyer gets a 5-minute major for face mask. We mentioned before, two players for each team hitting after the whistle, fighting after the whistle, I believe was a call, actually. Player getting pulled down, another penalty will be called. This one will be on St. Cloud State. And it's going to be number 7. I believe Nick Paling, not happy with it, but he's going to go into the box.
A 7-2 still, 5 minutes left in this game. Union more than earned the right to play in the championship game tomorrow, assuming they hold on to this one. So we see a 5-on-3 now for Union.
So a 5-on-3 for the Dutchmen. Looking for their 8th goal. Rinaldi with it. Rinaldi fanning on it. Another shot in front. Goes away. Rinaldi. Great passing back and forth, but Fu's not able to get onto it. Ryan with it. Ryan back to Rinaldi. Rinaldi with a shot. Blocked away by Smith. Morgan to Rinaldi to Ryan. Ryan at the point. Dropping off to Rinaldi. Another shot. Players in front. And he goes all the way back down. So a minute 30 remaining on the 5-minute major and a minute 15 on the penalty to number 7, Nick Paling.
Miss Union for Union. They've scored 3 power play goals in their last 2 games. Before that, 6-game scoreless streak. Of course, ending that with 3 goals, 3 power play goals in 2 games is the right way to do it. They have a 5-on-3 here.
Estes. Back to Sapinski. Sapinski to Estes. He fans on that one and only got a little piece of it. St. Cloud State will send it back down the ice. Killing off some more time. 40 seconds remaining in the 2-minute minor. 50 seconds on the major penalty. Three minutes and 30 seconds remaining here in the first game of the Three Rivers Classic. Set right back down by the Huskies. 15 seconds on the minor penalty. 20 on the major. Walker fighting for it. Brierley's able to keep it in. Feynman diving for it. St. Cloud State returning a player to the ice. 2-on-1, Paling, he was looking for the attacker again, and the net gets dislodged. Looking to try and pass it over. Good defense from the Dutchman, blocking the pass. Both penalties expire for the Huskies. 2 minutes and 50 seconds remaining here in this game.
Great job by St. Cloud State there for killing that and not letting any more damage to happen. Any this lead to be, you know, go to six. 2:50 left. Union up five still.
Perbix over. St. Cloud State winning the faceoff. Couple players fighting for getting his stick caught on a Union player, and I believe going to have a penalty. And it's going to be on Union College, number 14, for the Dutchman. And you go to the box. Lucas Bro.
And another penalty. I guess I did jinx him, Spencer. Although, of course, you know, anytime a lead like this, there's about to be some emotions come out.
So Lucas Bro is in the penalty box. A power play for St. Cloud State. An immediate timeout. We'll take a quick timeout as well. Union up 7-2, but the Huskies have a power play here at RMU Athletics. Here at RMU Athletics. Union in the penalty box, St. Cloud State on a power play. Bro had 2 minutes for holding. So St. Cloud State can try and get a goal here on the power play. Newell with it. 2 minutes and 15 seconds remaining in the game. And the Dutchman send it all the way back down. Radzinski, off Fitzgerald, back to Radzinski. Brierly stopping in the corner. Jackson with it for the Huskies. Back to Jackson. Jackson with a shot. I believe that somebody got a piece of that one. It goes wide. It'll bounce all the way back down. 50 seconds remaining on the power play. Taken away. Foo with a shot. Smith makes the save. Three players fighting in the corner. Brzezinski will take it out. Final minute of the third period in the game. Walker dropping off to Benson. That one going off of a St. Cloud State player. That one, not a good look.
Yeah, and a lot of RMU fans starting to arrive. Probably didn't expect to walk into this type of game.
Final 7 seconds of the penalty as Union College sends it all the way back down the ice. They will kill off this penalty. Returns their player to the ice. Final 30 seconds here at the Lemieux Sports Complex. Henkes in front, blocked off the pad of Hansen. Meyer. That one thrown in front. Meyer again, backhand. Goes off of Smith. Final 3 seconds in Union College, 14th ranked in the nation. They score 7 goals on the number one team in the country, St. Cloud State, and they will move on to the Three Rivers Classic Championship game tomorrow night at 8 p.m. Final score, Union defeats St. Cloud State 7-2. We thank you all for tuning in here on RMU Athletics. Of course, St. Cloud State will play tomorrow at 5 p.m. Union College will play tomorrow at 8. For our entire broadcasting crew, for our director, Becky Schoeniger, our producer, Kenya Johns, for my color commentator, Logan Carney, my name is Spencer Witt, saying so long and thank you for tuning in here on RMU Athletics and on RMU Radio, your campus, your voice. Good night, everybody.